All right, so I'm not one that usually makes product announcement videos, and this particular announcement came out 12 days ago, so you can already tell I'm on a great path here. But I feel like this announcement has kind of been slept on a little bit by the community, and I wanted to add a few of my thoughts here and talk about why this is really important. So Voiceflow recently announced the ability to embed the web chat into a web page directly through their own supporting script. And why is this important? So the majority of Voiceflow chatbots that are out there, we're all familiar with the widget, which is the bubble that comes up in the bottom right-hand corner. And we all live in this particular widget that has a small screen size in the right-hand corner and all of the limitations that come from this widget. Now, I've had the ability to build out full page and half page and custom chat flows for a few months now. And this is an example of my assistant that's currently live on my website. And one of the common questions that gets asked him is, "Hey, how do you do this? How do I make this happen on my website?" Now, what did we have to do in order to build this before? And the answer is you had to know HTML and CSS. Because we'd have to inspect the page and we have to go look through, what is Voiceflow calling this? What is Voiceflow calling that? You had to go, it was very cumbersome and you had to accumulate all of these puzzle pieces and then use your knowledge of HTML and CSS to put those puzzle pieces back together. Now, the reason that I didn't talk about this a whole lot or come out with any videos and stuff like that is my own knowledge of HTML and CSS, it's right now, it's rather elementary, okay? And I was leaning on one of my business partners to do this. And if I couldn't replicate it consistently, I wasn't going to make a video expecting you to do that either. And the other thing that I didn't want to do was say, "Hey, I can do this. You can do it too. Go learn HTML or CSS," because that's kind of a large ask for somebody to go do in order to get this functionality. But I believe that's about to change, and I'm going to explain why here. So Voiceflow is now natively supporting embedding the entire chat window into a web page. And the way that you do this is by targeting whatever the particular HTML element that you want to drop this web chat into. And I'll show you this demo that I put together real quick to give you an idea of what this really means. So here is a normal website page here, and you see we do not have a widget in the bottom right-hand corner. But if we scroll down, you see now I have, this is a Voiceflow assistant right here. And instead of the widget, I have it as a container that has a particular height and width to it. And it's a lot easier to read this long text. Because one of the main feedbacks I get from some of my clients is, it's like, "Yeah, this is great that it's providing all of this information. But, my users, they've got to scroll up in order to read this giant, amount of text." And depending on your application, there's a lot of advantages to building out larger context windows. And what this is going to allow you to do is kind of create these unique web pages that have the chat window functionality in mind when you're building it out, and you can provide some unique, seamless experiences for some of your users. Now, the reason that this is important and that Voiceflow is now natively supporting this is instead of you having this knowledge of HTML and CSS in order to find the puzzle pieces and put them together, you can now Voiceflow is giving you the key basically to the door and saying, "Here's what you need. It's this one little addition to your script. Here's the entire puzzle." Okay. And then you can take that puzzle and start adjusting it as kind of a whole unit. And so for those that are using page builders, like in WordPress or Webflow or Wix, we can just create the container and add the stylings that we want to it, and then have the Voiceflow assistant target that container and drop it right into a web page. So what it's going to do is, this is going to lower the bar significantly on people having the ability to do this, which is great to see. And I definitely plan on, you know, making some videos over the next few weeks that kind of go over this in more details. But the reason that this is great is because I can now go to a client and say, hey, you know, if you want the widget, it's X price. But then I have an upsell, which is X plus Y, which is a custom web page that I can design for you with this chat component in mind. And what this allows us to do is, it's the value proposition. Our main value proposition is that these AI assistants extend the functionality of your website. Well, here is another wrinkle to it. Here's another unique thing that I can do. So for us as chatbot builders, you have to ask yourself a question here. Is, do I want to take some time here and learn this and figure out how to do this and create these custom experiences for potential users, which I can then sell to clients? Or the other option is, maybe I need to start a partnership with a web development company or a website web design company, right? And then you can offer this to their clients as well. And that's the particular route that I'm taking, because I want to stay focused, you know, in the designer, in Voiceflow, and adding out functionality to my particular assistants. And instead of going and learning web design and all these different tools, all these different things, I can partner with them and give them a piece of the pie. And it's a win-win situation for both sides. So I'm personally excited to get in here and start building out more demos and examples of this, because I think it's really going to help increase the conversions you get on some of your sales calls. Because if you can put on a demo with these websites, with chats embedded directly inside of it, I think it's a really nice touch. And your potential clients are going to appreciate that you've taken the time and effort to put on these types of demos for them. So great update from Voiceflow. I'm glad to see it happen, and more to follow. Talk to you guys later. Thanks.